Coming into this program, one of the things that I saw in my interview day was just how close the residents and the faculty are. And I would say that's still just as true. Our faculty and attendings are always there to help, no matter what the question is, or as simple or complex as the question is. When you're on site and at your rotations, they're always available. But even after hours, we've had residents call attendings in the middle of the night, and they're still always available to help us. So I feel that you're always well supported, and you're given the supervision that you need, but also the autonomy when you feel like you can make decisions on your own.
I know that when I leave here, I'll be well trained. I'll be a very competent psychiatrist. I'll be able to go literally anywhere in the nation, in the country, and be able to practice above the standard of care. I feel like we get enough autonomy here to really build confidence in your skills and your skill set, so that when you leave here, you feel like you have necessary tools to go out and treat patients well.
I think that some of the unique aspects of our program are that despite being a relatively small program in a mid-sized city, we have a wide variety of opportunities for our residents. So our residents get the opportunity to work at a variety of locations around the city because we are, although a university-affiliated program, we are community-based. So our residents are rotating all around the city at private institutions, public institutions. We're really seeing the full gamut of populations that a city the size of Tulsa has to offer.
So one of the really unique things about this program is you actually get a month of research starting your intern year. So that gives you the opportunity right from the get-go to, you know, start a long-term project if that's something that you're really interested, or go ahead and finish a scholarly product that you need for graduation purposes.
We have the privilege of being able to have access to Library Laureate Institute for Brain Research, which is a wonderful research facility that they're doing a lot of different clinical trials and cutting edge type of projects. So depending on what you're interested in, if you're interested in more bench top research or more clinical studies research or even quality improvement, I feel like our program offers a wide range of that.
In the intern year of training, we have 4 months of primary care, 2 months of which are inpatient and 2 months of which are outpatient. Typically, our interns do that in our family medicine and community medicine sites, but they also have the option to do that training in internal medicine or the pediatrics departments. Our interns also do 2 months of outpatient neurology, 5 months of inpatient psychiatry divided up between our two different inpatient sites, one a private hospital and one a public hospital, as well as 1 month of a research elective. In the didactic curriculum, our interns have 6 months of intern core didactics, where it's just interns and they are learning together the basics of psychiatry before joining the rest of the classes in didactics. Something that I'm particularly proud of for our program is that we have been leaders, both regionally and nationally, in terms of our neuroscience education and training for our residents, as well as our wellness initiatives. And this is something that we also hope to continue in our diversity, equity, and inclusion efforts.
Not only do we do a great job teaching and seeing a wide variety of pathology, but we also incorporate resident wellness. This has been a great experience for my own personal growth and professional growth. Within it, we've been able to expose our residents to new ways to cope with any type of stress by teaching them like meditation or doing more visual guided meditation, along with like professional development. And it's been a really nice opportunity to have while here at this residency.
We also do a lot of get-togethers, like mm-hmm. Asha was saying. We have resident retreat every year that's been really fun. We do different types of activities, whether that's going to flying to your Topgolf, gathering at another resident's house. So we do a lot of different activities to promote wellness and to kind of build a strong support system and a sense of community that everybody can feel included and feel comfortable. And there's a lot of things that you can do here, from the nature walks and outdoor activities. There's a state park nearby, which is awesome. Arts that you can get into. The museums here are wonderful.
The food scene has still been pretty good. You get a wide variety of restaurants in town, and there's always new places popping up that our residents always try to have social events at.
One of the things that we're asked about frequently is our psychotherapy training. So that was actually one of the things that initially drew me to our program, was my interest in learning psychotherapy. So I'd say that our program has a balanced approach to both biological and psychosocial interventions. We do have very robust psychotherapy training.